Hi everyone, and welcome to Monday's phonics session. So for this week of phonics sessions, our main focus is going to be tricky words, because we've looked at phase three now, we've looked at phase four, so we're going to have a week on tricky words. Because remember, in year one, it's not only important to be able to read the tricky words, we have to also be able to write them. So we're going to have a little bit of reading and writing of tricky words within each session. We'll also look at one tricky word per session, but really our activity is going to focus on all of our tricky words from phase two all the way up to phase five. So before we get started with our tricky wordness, let's recap our phase three sounds. You can mute me and do them yourself. You don't have to listen to me saying the sounds, but if you're not sure on a couple of them, you can also not mute me and read along with me. But of course, feel free to mute me and read the sound yourself. Let's go. A, E, I, O, U, like moon, U, like book, R, or, ow, oi, ear, air, your,
So now for our tricky word that we're focusing on today, I'm going to give you a clue. I'm going to say a question, but leave the tricky word blank and see if you can figure it out. Would you like for dinner? Would you like for dinner? Any ideas? Would you like for dinner? What? Good. What is our tricky word? I wonder if you can spell it. Remember, we use the letter names when we're doing tricky word spelling, not the sounds, because we can't sound tricky words out. Have a go at spelling it. Well done. Right. Now I'm going to model writing it. So we start with, that's right, a W. Down, up, down, up. Now I'm doing this one-handed, so yours is going to be much neater. Then we've got the H, and that is a one-armed robot letter. So we start here because it's an ascender. We go down, up, and around, and flick. WH. Good. A, curly caterpillar letter. Around, up, down, and flick. W-H-A-T. Now remember, with our T, we don't go all the way to the top like with a H. We go halfway up, down, flick, and cross on the line. W-H-A-T spells what? Well done. Pause the video now and see if you can have a go at writing our tricky word for the day. Maybe you could include it in a sentence.
Well done. I hope you've had a good go at writing our tricky word, what. Here's a little song to help you. We sing it at school. You might recognise it. A whoop with a hat spells what? A whoop with a hat spells what? Just a good way of remembering. So, now it's time for our main activity. Now, back in a video, I can't remember when, a good couple of weeks ago now, I set you the challenge of making your own tricky word flashcards. Now, if you didn't get round to watching that, that's okay, or you didn't see it, that's fine. Pause the video now. That's your first challenge. If you have not got a set of your own tricky word flashcards, pause the video now to make some. If you've already got your own set of tricky word flashcards, it'll be a good idea to as well pause the video and make another set so you've got two sets. Because for this week, we'll be playing some games where you need two sets of tricky word flashcards from phase two to phase five. I'll leave the tricky words on the screen now for you. Pause the video now and complete your first task, either making two sets of tricky word flashcards if you haven't done already, or making another set if you've already got a set. See you soon. Right then, now it's time for our main activity. So you'll need one set of your tricky word flashcards today. Then you'll need some things from your kitchen. It might be a sieve, some saucepans, a wooden spoon, anything like that from your kitchen, just like I have. You'll then have to stick some of your tricky words on these items and have a tricky word kitchen disco. Here's what happened when I had mine. Sorry, mums and dads. Are you ready for a tricky word kitchen disco? Grab your flashcards, grab a sieve, let's go. Here's what happened when I had mine. Have fun. So you can be as creative as you like. It'd be great to see some of your kitchen discos on the year one email address. Maybe someone could film you. Go crazy. I'm sure I'll be able to give out lots of dojo points for creativity. Maybe even some for health, if you're jumping around the kitchen like I was. Have fun, and I'll see you tomorrow for some more tricky words.